Hi friends, welcome to Neon Forge. To watch more interesting videos, do hit the like, share and subscribe buttons of our channel. In this video, we shall see about one of the world's lost ancient treasures. Come, let's find about its origin and value. The Romanov's Eggs. The Romanov's extravagant royal Easter egg tradition began with Tsar Alexander III in 1885. Alexander was then in the fifth year of his reign, having succeeded his father Alexander II, who had been killed by bomb-wielding assassins. In 1885, Alexander sought an Easter gift to surprise and delight his wife, Maria Fyodorovna, who had spent her early years as a Danish princess before leaving Copenhagen to marry him and become a Russian empress. He turned to Peter Carl Fabergé, a master goldsmith who had taken over his father's House of Fabergé jewelry business in 1882. Instead of crafting a dazzling necklace or a breathtaking ring, Fabergé created something deceptively plain, a white enameled egg around 2.5 inches tall. But the real treasures were to be found inside. The egg twisted apart to reveal a golden yolk within. Inside the yolk was a golden hen sitting on golden straw. Hidden in the hen was a tiny diamond crown that held an even tinier ruby pendant. This astonishing creation, known as the hen egg, was the first of an eventual 50 Fabergé imperial eggs commissioned annually by the Romanov family's two final tsars, Alexander III and from 1894, Nicholas II. Fabergé crafted the initial eggs according to Alexander's specifications. In 1897, Nicholas II gave his wife Alexandra the imperial coronation egg. The shell is made of gold embellished with translucent yellow enamel and overlaid with black enamel double-headed eagles. Inside the white velvet-lined egg is an exquisitely detailed miniature 18th century golden carriage. The object, which took more than a year to create, is a replica of a coach once owned by the Catherine the Great and used in Nicholas and Alexandra's own 1896 coronation procession. The 1901 Gatchina Palace egg, which Nicholas II gave to his mother Maria Fyodorovna, has a pearl-encrusted shell of gold enamel, silver gilt, portrait diamonds and rock crystal. It opens to reveal a faithful rendering of the palace Maria called home. The Bolsheviks' February Revolution arrived in 1917 and Nicholas II was forced to abdicate the throne. His entire family was executed by Bolsheviks the following year. So what became of the imperial eggs? Under the orders of new leader Vladimir Lenin, the Bolsheviks packed up the eggs and other royal valuables they found at the imperial palaces and stashed them safely at the Kremlin in Moscow. They were lost in some dark passage in the Kremlin armory storerooms. Nobody knew where they were. But Lenin's efforts to preserve Russia's cultural heritage were undermined when Joseph Stalin came to power. Stalin began trading the Russian imperial legacy for desperately needed Western currency to support his new regime. The treasures were rediscovered somewhere around 1927. For the communists, there was the idea at the back of their minds that these things might actually be sold for the good of the new Bolshevik government to finance their economic plans. So these things were taken out of safekeeping, appraised and offered to the West. Of the 50 imperial eggs made, only 10 remain in the Kremlin. 8 imperial eggs are still missing. The mystery surrounding the lost eggs perpetuates their legendary history of being seen only by an elite few. These things were never shown to the Russian public. The excess of the eggs and their seclusion from the public reflect the elitist, out-of-touch final years of Tsarist Russia. They may be masterpieces, but they only embody extravagance that even the Romanov's most ardent supporter would find hard to justify. Thank you for watching this video. See you in another exciting video. Bye.